consonant.
Thank you. We'll start with L.
And another one.
S.
And a third consonant.
V.
And a vowel.
A.
And another vowel.
E.
And another vowel.
A.
And another consonant, please.
P.
A consonant.
R.
And another vowel, please.
And lastly, U.
Time starts now. Kate?
7.
And Helen?
7.
OK, what's your 7, Helen?
Valuers.
And yours, Kate?
Perusal.
Nice.
Sevens. Sevens over there in Dictionary Corner, or better than that?
We had a 7 for valuers, the same, and then we had palavers.
Very good.
You think of it as a noun normally, but it can be a verb as well, so you can say to somebody, stop palavering about, which is quite nice.
OK. Kate's 57, Helen has 19 at the moment. Here's our next letters round. Kate, it's your choice, please.
A vowel, please.
Start with O.
And another.
E.
And another.
A.
Consonant.
D.
And another.
M.
And another.
T.
And another.
N.
A vowel, please.
I.
And a consonant, please.
And finally, G.
And your 30 seconds starts now. Helen?
8.
And Kate?
8.
OK, what's your 8, Kate?
Dominate.
OK, and yours, Helen?
Demoting.
Demoting. Yeah, both very good 8s. Can you match it?
Yeah, we can match it. We can't beat it. We had dominate and demoting as well.
OK. So, we should check your paper, really, shouldn't we? Just to make sure.
Yes.
Yes. We'll accept it. It's time for our contestants just to take a short breather because it's that time in the programme where we cross to Susie. She's going to tell us about the origins of some words. Sporting theme yesterday. Is it the same today, Susie?
Yes. I thought I'd just stick up for the game of lacrosse because whenever I mention that I used to play lacrosse, people think, you know, jolly hockey sticks, convent girl, St Trinians and that kind of thing. But actually, it was such a violent game. I just had so many bruises from it. But it's a really tough sport. And when you know the history of it, it's not really surprising because it goes way back to the 15th century. And it was originally played by North American indigenous tribes as a means of training for war, believe it or not. And they called it Bagataway at that time and played it on a huge pitch. It was about 1/2 kilometre long. And the game was really violent. There were no rules to it at all. And each tribe had their own version of it. So they could just basically do what they wanted. But the Cherokee tribe in particular played it with hundreds and hundreds of people, and they called it the Little Brother of War, again, with that sort of the martial theme. But it was only much later that it was adopted as a sport, and it was given the name lacrosse by French settlers, in fact, because lacrosse is a name for a hooked stick, or more specifically, a bishop's crozier, and that was what the stick looked like. But there you go, it's a very warlike sport, and I'm going to stick up for it the rest of my life.
Very much like Australian rules football, in truth, which is most inappropriately named because it has no rules whatsoever, or so it would seem. Kate, 65, Helen, 27. Here's our next numbers round, and Helen, it's your selection, please.
Can I have 1 large and 5 small?
Thank you, Helen. We'll do an inverse T again. I like that one. So for this round, we've got 7, 9, 2, 10, 4, and the large one, 50. And the target is 602.
And you have 30 seconds to hit that target. Sitting comfortably and confidently here, I think. Helen?
Yes, 602.
And Kate?
602.
Helen, let's hear your version.
10 plus 2 is 12.
10 plus 2 is 12.
Times the 50.
Times the 50 is 600.
And 9 minus 7 is 2.
9 minus 7. Lovely. 602.
Same method, Kate?
I just did mine the other way around. I did the 9 and the minus the 7 at the beginning and then the 2 at the end.
Okay. 602 for both of them. Very well done. Here's a teaser for you. The words are look, draw, look, draw. And the clue, in the forest, fool around with a bird. In the forest, fool around with a bird. Back in a moment. In the forest, fool around with a bird. Of course, the answer is woodlark. Kate, 75. Helen, 37. On to our next letters round. Kate, your pick, please.
Vowel, please.
Thank you, Kate. A.
And another.
O.
And another.
E.
A consonant.
D.
And another.
B.
And another.
D.
And another.
N.
And another.
G.
And a vowel, please.
And the final one, O.
And your 30 seconds starts now. Helen, what have you found?
A 6.
And Kate?
6.
OK, Kate, what's yours?
Banged.
Banged, yeah. And yours, Helen?
Banded.
And banded. A couple of good sixes, yeah. Does bongoed count as a 7?
No, I looked it up because I thought it would be so nice, but it's only there as a noun, sadly, not as a verb.
What else have you got, then?
We've had to go for the ever so tasteful bondage.
OK. Kate has 81, Helen has 43 at the moment. Still a little way to go, though. On to our next letters round. Helen, it's your choice.
A consonant.
Thank you.
X. Ooh, a better consonant.
H.
A third consonant.
N.
And a vowel.
E.
And a second vowel.
I.
And a third one.
A.
And a consonant.
P.
And another consonant.
R.
And final vowel.
And lastly, I.
And here's the countdown clock.
I think.
Helen?
6.
OK, what's the 6 you're thinking about then, Kate?
Pannier with one N.
Interesting. OK, and your 6, Helen?
Harpy.
Harping.
Harpy.
Harpy. Well, I did check that, and unfortunately, in the singular, it has to have the Y, unfortunately. And pannier, I'm pretty sure in French it's one N, and in English it is two Ns, I'm afraid, Kate. So, can't allow either.
OK.
Sorry.
What could we have allowed? What have you got over there?
Could have allowed a hairpin for 7.
Mm. Mm. One word.
all one word.
Yeah.
Okay, very good indeed. Let's move on to our next letters round. And Kate, it's your choice this time.